Okay, now I want to talk about custom patches, let's say. There's also an announcement that this design is now finally done. Also, I was working on it quite a long time, but it was a hard time to convert the drawing over into an, let's say, 3D printable file. So yeah, now it's finally done, and I'm happy that I kind of put that, let's say, that test to rest, and that I kind of have a sort of closure with that. But yeah, that was also a good moment to kind of talk about custom patches, because as a paintball player, I'm surrounded with patches a lot. You got event patches. Usually those are made out of PVC. Downside to those is that you need a higher quantity to let the PVC patches be made. Exact prices depend on, of course, the company that makes them and things like that, but that's in general the rule. And also, of course, there's a limited color palette. Some make it really flat, so it's kind of a flat patch. Sometimes it got a little bit of a 3D effect to it. This one doesn't have that, so I cannot really show it. But then you got a little bit of staggered things on there. Something that you can technically also do with 3D printing. Me kind of wanting to do things myself a lot of times. In the past I've kind of done this. This is just a few layers of cotton, and then I ironed on, let's say you got those iron-on prints you can make on usually used on t-shirts, things like that. That's kind of how I did this. I just printed that on the special paper that you can use an iron and ironed on cotton. Then using special, let's say, glue, and glued a few layers of cotton on together so it was a little bit more thick. And I stitched some Velcro on the back, and this top layer was glued on late so you don't see the stitching. This works, but with paintball, especially when it gets hit, it kind of wants to creep a little bit in the fabric, so it was harder to clean. So later on I did also apply the clear lacquer on it, and if you do that nicely, it will last you a few years. These are getting a little bit old, but you can see this one is more glossy. So if you like that, you do it a few layers and then it's more glossy. If you do it really thin, then it will just seal up the, let's say, the texture of the fabric. So you don't have to worry about, let's say, paint or mud, things like that. Depends on what you are doing in your life. But it does help, but in the end, later will kind of, yeah, get damaged on the sides especially. But the glue that I kind of use for this fabric, it does help also with the unraveling of the fabric. So that's a thing to keep in mind. A future plan I have with this tactic is to just print on, let's say, a synthetic fabric. And those you can also kind of use a lighter or any or something like that, and kind of burn off the edges so that it doesn't unravel. And that is something that I kind of am planning in the future to do, because I do kind of like, it's maybe subtle, but you do kind of get a little bit more of color changes, and I do like that. And sometimes I miss that kind of with the PVC ones. Another way to go about that as well is, of course, go with stickers. These are done with stickers. Downside of that, of course, it can kind of peel on the edges in the end. But again, it will last quite a long time, and it doesn't cost much. So you can at a certain time choose to peel this one off and then apply a new one if you make a few of them. How I did this one is, it's a layer of ABS plastic, a sheet of ABS plastic that I kind of cut by hand. So this is really, in the case if you do it by hand, really only if you want to have one for yourself or stuff like that. It's not for a high quantity. But of course, I can imagine if you have a laser cutter, you can do that with a laser cutter, and then it's a lot faster and easier to make. Then you apply on the other side Velcro with adhesive on there. let it dry up, things like that, and you got yourself a patch. It's relatively stiff, of course, but it bends a little bit. So yeah, it depends on how flexible something needs to be. It cannot beat the PVC ones, but it's fine. I think it's a fun option to do in case you want to have a really low or special, only a personal patch, let's say. Do apply some laminate, it's called. It's, let's say, a clear plastic on top of the sticker. You can see that here I hit something like a wall or something. It kind of damaged it. But then you can see you can also start to damage the ink on the, let's say, the vinyl plastic that's printed on. And that's something you can kind of prevent a little bit by having the clear plastic that you kind of protect the paint, helping to last it longer. This one is really made with a home printer, so it's not really professional printed on vinyl, things like that. So that's why it looks a little bit less clear. But you got those strange spots in there, but in a way with this style it kind of works. But yeah, but if you do it professionally with a shop, it's not expensive to do, and you can make a few of them for yourself. Probably not to trade. Also with this one, it's quite labor intensive to do. You can take an A4 sheet of paper, and you can imagine you can iron those on a fabric and cut those, but that's really a lot of work for on your part. If you kind of are into that, then it's fine, but it's not something you're gonna trade with other people, things like that. It's a lot of work. Then of course I also kind of experimented with doing it with a 3D printer. This one was made with PETG. This was done as an image and did try the, let's say, the linear grab thing. The one I just showed you, I did it with this technique. So it, you can see it's plastic where you can, when you put a light behind it, you can kind of see through it like a painting. But since that one was a black and white image, so you can see now with normal lights you cannot really see much, but you can see some, let's say, height difference. And that's what's called, I believe, a linear lithograph. The way I did with this one was just take, let's say, a black and white image and just let the first few layers print in red, and then when it will get higher, because of the different, let's say, tone difference in the image, I decided to switch it over to black, and then I just stopped the print at a certain layer height. An advice with this is, and that's also sometimes what I find a kind of bit a bad thing about PVC patches, is don't make the height too big, because when you see it straight on, it will read clearly, but when you start to see it in angles, how higher you make it, how less clear it becomes. Especially with big words like this, it's fine, but with some, let's say, things that are really close together, you start to lose the details, the lines. You cannot see them anymore because it's like a high wall that gets thing. And that's the same sometimes with PVC patches. When you see them really from the side, it's not so clear as a sticker will be, because a sticker is flat, so you can read those shapes really clearly. There are still really hard shapes and even really steep angles, and that's what I kind of prefer. If you forget that this is just a sticker, because people will say, ah, just a sticker, that's silly, that's cheap, but it does really read really clear. So even though this is just a simple green on black print, and not with, let's say, it's not the best example, but you can see that it got a lot more tones to it. It still reads a lot clearer than this one, because when you put it in an angle, it starts to get, and also this one is smaller, that's true, but if you put it in an angle, you can see that some lines will get a little bit unclear, let's say. So that's also something to keep in mind when you start to do it with this. This model is really made as an STL, So you can just decide yourself, let's say, to print it all in one color and paint it yourself. I do have to say, it did not really work out so well. I was thinking like, okay, let's try it. Just print it all in one color and just paint it by hand. But just putting it, just painting the things that sticking up. That did not work out. That was not really easy, let's put it that way. And at a certain point I was going over it, and then I was kind of like, oh, let's pick a really dry paintbrush and make it really like, give it a little bit of a weathered look to it. That was not really nice. It didn't really read clear, so I have to go over with some black paint and kind of paint everything black again, so it was really a clear definition between the gold and the black, so it reads really clear. So sure, you don't really get this type of shine when you're using gold or silk PLA, but I would recommend just going with two color print, doing color change. It's a lot less labor on your part, and it's a lot clearer to do. Thing, but that is maybe just me. When you do this linograph technique, I do find that it's kind of pixelated. So if you can, try to make it as an STL design if you want to do something like a patch, because then the lines are really just curves, and it's not like an it's like a difference between vector images and pixel images, because then the 3D printer with this one will really try to make it all out of pixels, and you can see that a little bit. It's some more than others, but I don't really see people really talk about what the best resolution would be, because it's not necessarily in high resolution, I've noticed. But there is some resolution that is really a little bit less severe than, let's say, the other one. Anyhow, so if you can, it's better to do it with this. This one have played one event on there with paintball. You can see it does hold up, but if it is a little bit like something like a wall, or I got a vest that I put over it and snacks on there, okay, it will kind of break. So you got a little bit of damage there. Also, there should be, you can see it with the big one on the back, there should be a line right here. That one broke off on this one. Also, I just noticed that this line right here is not, it's also damaged by something. So yeah, is this the most sturdy design you can do as a patch? No, because the lines are, they are put when this black is kind of cooling off, because you do the color change, so the adhesive is not that strong. So probably when you really rub it against something, or you're bumping against a wall or something like that, it may get damaged, but it does have a kind of nice look to it. But clearly it cannot beat the let's say durability of a PVC patch. But this is just something I wanted to show, because this is done with PLA plus, and also with this one, if you do the velcro with adhesive on the back, it will look fine. Is this one flexible? A little bit, but it's quite stiff. The patchy one, even though this one is thicker, is a little bit more flexible because it's patchy, it's more flexible. But yeah, that's also a thing. Don't make it too thick, but also as if in regards with paintball, you don't want to make it too thin, of course, because when it gets hit by a paintball, you don't want it to crack. That's kind of, let's say, embarrassing. But I believe 1 millimeter, let's say, as the base layer, the background layer, is enough. And then the other layer, keep it really thin. Just enough that it kind of is clearly visible from the base layer. But I would not make it necessarily higher than you need to be, because again, otherwise you get kind of the reading issues if you really make it high. But yeah, this is a tall edition of it. If you do print patches like this, especially if it's like just 10 centimeters, so it's just for on your arm or stuff like that, when it gets relatively tiny. You will print it like this on your print bed. So don't use the 0.4 nozzle for this. Just swap out the nozzle to an 0.2 nozzle, so you can kind of get away a nicer shapes on their details and lines, things like that. Will it take quite some time? Yeah, sure. But you do have to keep in mind, just make the layer height quite high, because that is not relevant, because you print flat anyway. They are flat layers. But yeah, it still takes a lot of time, especially when you have this large one, to fill up this entire space with a small nozzle. But yeah, you need to have to... depends on how the design is, how detailed it is, but in this case it was kind of nice to give all the details in the FTC9s to see that, and kind of see also like, is it worth it and things like that. So yeah, that was it about the patches. I hope that was kind of interesting to see. Also, this, so to be clear, if you want to have this design, you can find it in the links below. It will be in this scale. If you want to have it bigger, you can just scale it up in Cura. Just scale it up to the size that you want, and then just make sure that the Z height, so that is the height that goes this way, just keep that on 100%, so that keeps the height the same, but then you can, let's say, 200% this direction and this direction, and then you can scale it up so big or smaller as you want. I figured out that way is kind of more easy to do, because, and also really customizable for yourself, because at first I was thinking about making a few different sizes, but then I was kind of like, oh, you can just scale it in Cura, so it's way easier for me as well to make, because it's quite an heavy design to make in the program that I was using. But I'm glad it's completed, and that after all the errors, I needed to figure out what was wrong with let's say the translation from digital drawing to, let's say, 3D model. Then that was finally figured out. I was kind of happy that's done, because I gave it a few tries, a lot of hours. Finally just figured out, like, okay, let's just dissect every part of the drawing, and let's figure out what's actually going on, what's giving the error. Anyways, so as you can see, I've made quite a few different patches in the past. Probably will keep on thinking about new ways of doing it, because that's kind of my nature. I am. I like to think out of the box and do some crazy things. And some things work, some don't. The ones that really didn't work in the past, I have not shown those, because it's kind of an evolution. Because this was kind of the better way of going it with this type of style. But in the past, there was a few generations before that were less than ideal, let's say. This was kind of working quite well, but we have this for a few years right now, and you can see they start to kind of wear down a bit, but they did work out quite well. And you do notice nowadays that the PVC ones are getting really so common, they are not special anymore, that now this one are kind of getting sometimes a little bit of a look like, oh, there's something different, a different style. But when this was kind of new, then it was, oh, self-made ones, cheap, and things like that. But it's kind of funny how that goes. Now it's getting too normal, this one, too regular. And now the, let's say, self-made ones can be kind of more an head turner than the one that kind of was the thing in the past. But yeah. Anyways, I hope that kind of helps in case you want to kind of have a limited run for yourself and kind of give you some ideas. Maybe you do something totally different, but then you still got some ideas. I did also want to kind of try the TPU one and try that, but I did hear that kind of harder to print. Maybe also not so good with a small nozzle, I'm not sure. Also kind of wondered when it's more like a rubber Maybe it's more greasy and will also not stick so well with the Velcro. Just some things I'm thinking about and probably maybe totally not true. But yeah, in other words, I've not really tried it yet. That's why I don't have it. Otherwise, I would have shown it or told something more about it. But that's an idea as well, if you want to kind of have the flex of that. And also saw a nice technique with that one is, now of course you have the different height difference. And when you heat it up with the PVC ones, I've seen a trick with that, then it kind of melts more flat. And that's kind of a nice thing, because then you also don't have those chances that the layer lines are bumped off, over. So that's maybe a thing that you want to consider. But I'm not sure if I can find that video back again with that technique. Because you do sacrifice a little bit of detail, of course. But yeah, it's maybe something you want to look out for. So I took, I was listening to the video when I was editing about the TPU and the heat gun. And I was thinking, why do I not actually try it with this one that isn't done in PLA Plus? Because otherwise, I may ruin it, but at the same time, when I keep on wearing it with the PAML event, eventually you may bump off a letter and then it's kind of ruined as well. So just give it a try. I do have the impression, but I did not really test it out before, but the layers are quite on there, let's say the different colors. Of course, if you really want to, you keep on pressing, you may start to push it off. Now I do it really soft, but I did kind of try to remove it with my fingernails by pressing it sideways, things like that. So it does kind of seem well, you are heating it up and try to do this evenly on not too high of a setting, that it kind of starts to melt a little bit better together. You don't get really the glossy effect. Maybe if you start to go longer on it, it does, because there are some parts that do start to shine a little bit. But you do have to keep in mind, based on the fact that now the glue is sticking out sideways, the PLA Plus will shrink a little bit. The same that you can kind of see when you do it in the oven to anneal it, I guess it's called. It will also give them shrinkage, so you may want to do that before you start to apply the Velcro on the back. And also keep in mind, it kind of wants to warp a little bit of the heat. So keep something close by hand, and of course bigger than this, but something to kind of, with some weight to it, to kind of put it back flat again. And that can handle some heat, of course. And don't press your fingers on it, because then you will put your fingerprints on it. That's evidence. Now and then you ruin the finish. You do can see that this corner was a little bit ugly. Maybe I made it a little bit too hot. I'm not sure what happened right there. This corner, of course, was already kind of ruined by that it was broken. But besides that, the finish is quite alright. But you can see, maybe it's not that clear, but for me it's clear that this part right here was getting a little bit hotter than the rest, so it's more glossy. But not really something you will notice that much. But so it is probably something you need to practice a little bit. But this may help with to make it a little bit stronger of a design, let's say. So the layers don't, the shapes don't fall off during gameplay, things like that. So this may be something to experiment with. So that's why I did this test. So to kind of see if that is something worth trying.